we will continue with croup, with the clinical features of croup. So we have seen the pathophysiology and how it is leading to respiratory failure, we have seen, and now we will continue with the clinical features of croup, especially acute laryngotracheal bronchitis. We know that there are four common manifestations for any croup syndrome, and it is the first one, acute laryngotracheal bronchitis. Definitely it has these all four symptoms, and other all manifestations also we can notice. And usually we cannot say that the person will be similar in all day or all patients will be in a similar condition. It is according to the progress of block or progress of obstruction. So if the person is in the stage one, like very minimum distress, there will be fear, like something is happening abnormal, have some air hunger, and that fear will be here, the hyoscines will be there, barking or resonant cough or brassy cough can be there, that is a dry, very irritating cough will be there, and some amount of inspiratory stridor at the stage one stage of the acute laryngotracheal bronchitis. In the stage two, when it is further narrowing happen, what can happen is continuous respiratory stridor. So initially it was only inspiratory stridor only during the inspiration. Now in both inspiration and expiration, we can see a stridor, that is continuous respiratory stridor will be the lower rib retractions will be the retraction of tissue of neck, use of accessory muscles will be noticed. And in stage 3, we can see some of the manifestations like anoxia, carbon dioxide retention, restlessness, anxiety, pallor, sweating, rapid respiration. And in the final stage 4, we can notice the person is going for respiratory failure with intermittent cyanosis, and later it becomes permanent cyanosis and cessation of breathing. So the person is going for respiratory failure. So these are the manifestation why we divided into different stages. It is the manifestations or the clinical features of the patient will be purely depending upon the degree of obstruction. How large the obstruction is, the depending upon that the manifestations will be varying, and it is slow and it is progressing type of manifestations can be seen. It will be slowly, it will be not slowly, it will be progressing. Next we can see the diagnostic measures. So in diagnosing croup, it is very important to consider and exclude other causes of shortness of breath and stridor, such as foreign body aspiration and epiglottitis. So if there is any foreign body is aspirated and it is obstructed in the upper airway, the similar manifestations can be seen. So if the person is presenting these all croup symptoms, we have to exclude other reasons of this respiratory stridor and any other shortness of breath. So we have to do that first, and history and physical examination should be done. And very importantly, one sign which is noticed in the x-ray of a child with acute laryngotracheal bronchitis is steeple sign. So you can notice the steeple sign in the x-ray. Steeple, it is nothing but nammal palligalde ellam christian palligalde ellam endha paraya mugalleke nokki kaiyal oru koorthu varum mugalleke koorthu varuna adineyana nammal steeple ennu parayanathu. So the same things can be seen in the x-ray because of the narrowing of the airway. More like ingana keri keri adu narrow aayi varunathu. So adindeyana on a frontal x-ray with of the cervical vertebrae, the steeple sign suggests the diagnosis of croup. So we have to take the x-ray, frontal x-ray, including the cervical area or the neck area. In that we can find the steeple sign. Steeple nu parayunnathu vera onnalla, more like ingana കുന്തം പോലെ ഇങ്ങനെ ഇങ്ങനെ കൂർത്തു വരുന്നതിനെയാണ്, മുകളിലേക്ക് പള്ളികളിലൊക്കെ കാണാം. സോ ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് എ സ്റ്റീപ്പിൾ സൈൻ. നെക്സ്റ്റ് വി കെൻ സീ ദ മാനേജ്മെൻറ്റ്. സോ ഇൻ മൈൽഡ് ക്രൂപ്പ്, എക്സ്പോഷർ ടു കോൾഡ് ഹ്യൂമിഡ് എയർ ക്യാൻ ബി സഫിഷ്യൻറ്റ്. ആൻഡ് ഇൻ മോഡറേറ്റ് ടു സിവിയർ ക്രൂപ്പ്, ദ പേഴ്സൺ മേ in moderate to severe croup, moderate to severe the person may require oxygen therapy, intravenous fluid administration, steroid injections, adrenaline like inhaled preparations. So this depends upon the condition of the child we have to give. If it is a mild croup, only cold humid air can be sufficient. And in moderate to severe croup, we may need oxygen therapy, intravenous fluid administration, steroid injections, adrenaline like inhaled preparation. So inhalations should be given and medicines should be given accordingly the condition of the child. And home care and treatment regarding, we can give some amount of mist, humid air can be given and mist can be given, warm fluids for coughing spasm, then acetaminophen and ibuprofen if temperature is there, calm and quiet environment can be given. And nursing management, continuing assessment, that is continuing or frequent assessment by the nurse, is essential to determine the child's respiratory obstruction because it is a progressing condition, inflammation can increase. So we should be monitoring the child continuously. And these assessment include the following, that is monitoring respirations for rate, depth, it is depth, okay, type, heart rate and regularity, then auscultation, lungs for breath sounds and the presence of rhonchae or rails, and we have to observe the flow, the flaring of nares, and substernal and suprasternal or intracoastal, intercoastal retractions, then hoarseness, cough, stridor, color of mucous membranes and skin, then restlessness and irritability. Then facilitation of respiratory efforts is again the nurse's responsibility. So respiratory efforts can be facilitated with high humidity atmosphere and oxygen, oxygen and the insertion of an artificial airway. So we can give oxygen, highly humidified oxygen can be given, or if it is needed, we have to give the artificial airway, and the person has to get tracheostomy care if the tracheostomy care is done. Tracheostomy is done for the child, and usually we will do tracheostomy because in the upper airway there is obstruction. So when you are putting a nasopharyngeal catheters or ET tube, there is no use of that. You have to go for tracheostomy because we have to pierce at the tracheo level because the obstruction can be there in the laryngeal level. So orally or nasally approaching the child is of no use in this condition. So what we do is tracheostomy, and tracheostomy care for the child like a suctioning and cleaning also should be done. So this is about the acute laryngeotracheobronchitis. It is one of the commonest condition and very commonly seen in children than any other conditions, but it is also one of the emergency condition and respiratory disorders and diseases of childhood. So I will stop, and the second croup condition we will discuss in the next video.